All the credits are using the time. I mean, not all the cutscenes use the timeline. Let me go into the project. So, like a good example would be when you go from the apartment to the office for the first time. Like, big spoilers here. Oh, I have to delete the cameras. Okay. There we go. So, for example, when you go from right when you have that cutscene that you go from being in the office in the apartment, and then you go straight to the first time you go into the office, and you feel you're going back in time to the flashback.
And you've got the rotate. Is that those are like the police sirens, right? Like
this is like the day. Don't see the day passing by
with the red and blue. Oh, I see.
It's like it's the cycle of the day, like many days passing, like day night cycle, kind of going back in time. But yeah, man, this was amazing. And it was funny because when I needed to do the phone, you guys dropped the new UI, and the timeline was updated. Like I remember I didn't use the timeline until it was like pretty solid, and when it was solid, it was great. Yeah, like dropping the objects here, yeah, the way you can use the assets, you can even convert these things into if you open the animator window, you can play with the curves, you can play with everything, and seeing it in real time is just.
And you're just changing that one layer. You're just changing the light, right? With all those.
Yeah, there's two lights that are rotating.
Yeah.
And turning on and off. Yeah, and change. Yeah. I think it's the same light. You're right. The same light rotating and changing color. Yeah. The timeline was used for all the cutscenes and transitions, and even the loop is a cutscene. It's a plane. It wouldn't make sense to see here, but like when you loop is there's a plane that fades in, does a render to texture from the last frame of the game that fades out as you go into the next scene. So I could even do these, like when you look at the pocket watch and it's fading in, right? I'm loading a cutscene with a timeline that's getting rendered to a texture that's getting slowly imposed on top of the gameplay, and I don't know much programming, right? I learned to program for this game, and I was like, wow, I can have this idea in my mind and then pull it off in Unity, versus right having someone write an animation tool that would take like a year plus debugging plus everything, and then maybe I change my mind and I don't want to do this anymore.